Hello friends, welcome to this new video. Today we are going to start a new topic of chapter 6 and it is social responsibility towards different interested groups. We know social responsibility has an element of voluntary action on the part of business person who is free to perform or not to perform such a responsibility. When we are talking about social responsibility, we need to decide what is right. Should we focus on maximizing profit of business only? Actually, when we say social responsibility means answering the question what is morally right and what is wrong for the society. Should business enterprise run for the benefit of its owner only? Or it need to be responsible for other sections of the society too, like customers, employees, suppliers, government and community at large. And they also have to decide to which extent they want to serve various sections of the society. So let's try to understand social responsibility of a business towards interested groups, like towards shareholders, owners or investors, towards employees or workers, towards consumers, towards government, towards community, and towards suppliers. Now let's see first social responsibility of business towards shareholders, investors or owners. First responsibility is to pay fair return on their investments in form of dividend or interest. Second is to ensure the safety of their investment. Next is to maximize the wealth of shareholders, which means increasing the market value of shares. Next is to provide regular, accurate and full information about working of business as well as schemes of future growth. Next is to protect the interest of all types of investors in the business. And the last is to give them opportunities to participate in the decision-making process. Next is responsibility towards workers or employees. First is to pay fair wages and salaries to workers or and employees. Next is to provide right kind of working conditions so that they can work efficiently. Next is to provide service benefits like medical facilities, educational facility to children, retirement benefit like provident fund, gratuity, housing facility and insurance. Next is to provide opportunities for the personal growth and development through training and education and involvement of workers in decision-making process when decisions are related to them, and to respect the democratic rights of the workers to form unions. And the last is to develop a sense of belongingness in the employees or workers towards the business. Next is responsibility towards consumers. First is to provide right quality and quantity of goods and services at reasonable prices. Next is to ensure regular and adequate supply of products. Next is to avoid unfair trade practices like adulteration, hoarding. Hoarding means purchase of large quantity of commodity by speculator with purpose of benefiting from selling it when price increase. Next is black marketing, means illegal trade of goods like weapon, drugs, smuggling of human organs. These are part of black marketing. Next is underweighing, and the next is a misleading advertisement. So these type of practices must be avoided by the businessman or business enterprise. Next is to inform the customer about new product and new uses of existing product, or handle the consumer's complaints promptly. And the last one is design and develop the products according to needs and requirements of consumers. Next is social responsibility of business towards government. First is to respect the law of the country, then to pay taxes regularly and honestly, adopt fair dealings in foreign trade so that country's reputation is maintained. Next is to support government in solving various national problems like poverty, illiteracy, overpopulation and unemployment. And the last is to cooperate in planning, investigation and administrative activities of the government. Next is social responsibility of business towards community. First is to behave like a good citizen and act according to the well accepted values of the society. Next is to protect natural environment by avoiding bad effluents, means waste discharge, smoky chimneys, dirty working conditions, etc. Next is to develop proper image in the society by continuous interaction with various groups of people, generating more employment opportunities for the people, promote national integration, preserve social and cultural values, and the last one is contribute in development of local area by providing facilities like drinking water, electricity, dispensaries, etc. And the last one is social responsibility of business towards suppliers. First is to ensure regular and timely payment to supplier, then adopt fair dealings with suppliers, then protect and assist small-scale suppliers by placing orders with them. Next is to guide the supplier in improving quality of their products. And the last is to keep the supplier informed about changes in consumer demands. So these are all social responsibilities of a business towards different interested groups. So here our topic is over. I hope you understand everything properly.